Yes, Republican Congressman David Dreier of California, Democratic Congressman Anthony Weiner of New York. Congressman Dreier, is the Senate Majority Leader right that it's not about money anymore, it's simply about funding for Planned Parenthood?
You know, Wolf, I listened to both John and Harry there, and it sounds to me like we're on the exact same page. It's about the issue of spending. John Boehner said that the policy issues have been by and large addressed, and Harry Reid said pretty much the same thing, it sounds like to me. And so this issue is about spending. Last November 2nd, the American people sent a very strong message, and we've been able to be successful at changing the trajectory, having gone through an 82% increase in non-defense discretionary spending under Speaker Pelosi's leadership. So we've changed that. I don't know exactly what the number is going to end up being. We'll find out in the next few hours, but I'm optimistic. I believe that we can, in fact, avoid a shutdown, which I think Democrats and Republicans alike have concluded would not be good.
All right, so I just want to be precise, Congressman Dreier. You will vote for it, assuming the number is there, even if it includes funding for Planned Parenthood.
Listen, you know, again, the policy issues have been addressed. I'm planning to support this package that John Boehner comes back with. I believe that he's been representing the interests of the American people, Democrats and Republicans alike, in his effort to deal with this. And remember, he said this earlier today to some of us, we've got the President of the United States, the Vice President of the United States, the Democratic leader of the United States Senate, 3-1. And I think that John Boehner is doing very well standing up for the American people on this issue of spending. Job creation and economic growth is what we want to do. We want to move on next week to the budget where we can bring about $6.2 trillion in spending cuts and implement a very strong pro-growth economic package. I don't want to point fingers at anybody.
All right.
I just want us to get this thing done.
Yeah, and Congressman Weiner, David Dreier is a member of the leadership in the House of Representatives on the Republican side. Sounds like you guys have a deal pretty much wrapped up if you listen to what he just said.
Well, if the voice of David Dreier and, frankly, if John Boehner's voice, if they were the ones that were prevailing in the Republican caucus, we would have had a deal a while ago. These are reasonable guys who want to do the right thing. The problem is it does seem like the straw that's stirring this drink are the Tea Party extremists who very much want to keep this language in about a woman's right to choose and try to litigate whether Environmental Protection Agency can have oversight over the environment. These things, the very fact that they're on the table, should raise questions in the minds of the American people. Why are these the issues or even being considered in the context of keeping government up and running?
I think it's been clear that they don't seem to be the issues any longer. They seem to be resolved, according to Speaker Boehner. And
I heard Wolf ask you a direct question about whether or not you'd vote for the thing if these things are taken out. We need people just to say, let's say, and by the way, some of the more extreme voices in the Republican caucus, even they have said, enough of dealing with all of these writers. Michelle Bachmann, who's hardly a mainstream person, even she said, take these things out. I think here's what would be the most salutary thing.
Congressman, let me interrupt for a second. The issue of the Environmental Protection Agency, the issue of an NPR, all that has been removed. The only issue that the Democratic leadership says remains is this issue of Planned Parenthood and abortion in the District of Columbia. That's the issue, apparently, if you believe Harry Reid, the Senate Majority Leader, that's still out there. Everything else basically has been worked out. Is it your understanding, Congressman Weiner, that they do have an agreement basically on the number, on the budget cuts?
Well, it's a little hard to say because at every point that a number has been articulated by Mr. Boehner, it has been agreed to in some form by the Democratic leadership, and then they've moved the number. So I don't know exactly what the number is any more than, frankly, you do. But I am suspicious of this whole idea that what Speaker Boehner is saying is true, that, oh, we're not fighting over the writers anymore. If that's the case, say so. Say so clearly that we're taking those things off the table, because certainly you don't have the votes are not going to appear and the president's not going to sign a bill that takes away a woman's
right
to choose.
I think he did say that. I mean, this is not about a woman's right to choose. This is about something that Harry Reid, Joe Biden, and Barack Obama have all supported, and that is ending taxpayer funding of abortion in the District of Columbia.
Not.
So what I'm saying is that let's not talk about those issues, because Speaker Boehner has said they have been by and large resolved. They're doing it. So we're not in the business. Neither Anthony Weiner nor David Dreier can put things on or take them off the table. That's been resolved. This is about spending. And frankly, on the Tea Party issue, you've got the Tea Party has nothing to do with these rider issues. Tea Party stands for taxed enough already. They want to reduce the size and scope of government, reduce the tax burden on working Americans so that we can get the economy growing. Those are the people who I think that's representative of Democrats and Republicans.
So the Tea Party caucus is going to be with you, David Dreier? Is that what you're saying?
Well, you know what? I mean, it sounds to me as if we can focus on getting a good, strong number, which John Boehner has been fighting for since day one, then I think that we can have very broad support across the spectrum within the Republican conference.
Well, first of all, to say that these writers are not the reason we're sitting here at the 11th hour is just to ignore what's going on. And I mean, frankly,
that's what John
if we
Boehner
did not
said,
have
Anthony.
Yes, that's also yes. Was Harry Reid said something different, and our intuition about what's going on tells us something different. Since the number hasn't been the hang-up since word go, we've reached the number four or five times, and four or five times, Mr. Boehner has left the table saying, "I need to work on these writers." Now he says they're resolved. I don't know. Frankly, we're hearing a lot of people say that that's the last remaining holdup, including our friend Wolf Blitzer, who just said it.
Now, Anthony Weiner, you know very well that you should have much more confidence in something said by a member of the United States House of Representatives and the United States Senate any day of the week.
I guess you do have me there. Usually they're not steering us in the right direction. But look, let's be clear about this. I do believe that there is a fundamental center in Congress and in the American people who are looking at this and say, let's not let these ideological issues get in the way of getting this
done. And they haven't. They've been resolved according to the guy who's our House colleague here, Anthony. And so let's not talk about that anymore. Let's talk about how we can, in fact, bring about spending. And I congratulate you, if you're going to support this package at the end of the day, for helping us bring an end to that trajectory of dramatic increase in spending and actually focusing on reducing the size
of the government. I think it's fair to say, gentlemen, if it were just Anthony Weiner and David Dreier, there would have been a deal a while ago. But
get out of the way, Wolf. Get out of the way, Wolf.
It's not just the two of you. There are a lot of others. Gentlemen,
thanks
very much.
And that's as James Madison wanted it.
Thanks very much for coming in.